goodness, see? Is that enough for you?
Brought to you in part by St. Croix Rods, best rods on earth. Strike King Lure Company, number one in fishing lures. Ardent, pure performance, all American. This week on Extreme Angler TV.
There you are. There's another one.
Boy, oh boy. Today I'm going to talk to you about punching little clumps of grass with a Strike King Rage Crawl.
We'll be right back.
Bring along the side. Maybe you'll come out and eat it. And it's just a small one. He's just a little guy. A little guy in the same kind of spots where there could be a big one. Look at that. Just a chunky little back on him. He's nothing big. But guess what we're gonna do today? Docks. We're gonna rock some docks. A nice sunny day. The weather's been consistent. Perfect conditions that I like to fish docks. Fish are on the feed bag, the sun's out, pushes them into places that are like this, with weed, docks, boats, you name it. I'm gonna show you everything I do to catch largemouth and maybe some smallmouth on boat docks today. Sit back, grab a beverage, and enjoy another episode of Extreme Angler TV, rocking the docks today. You know, when you're fishing docks, like I'm doing today, there's a couple things you gotta be aware of. That first pitch is paramount. I don't care if it's 10 inches deep or 10 feet deep. The biggest thing is, if there's a very aggressive fish there, as soon as your bait goes in, you know he's aware it's there. So with 10 feet, you gotta let it go and settle. Hence the choice for the soft plastics. Let him find it, turn, pick it up, and start to move. Those smaller fish usually be like, they'll run with it or be a real fast hit and they run. In fact, you know, that's telltale for either rock bass or small bass, smallmouth as well. But those big fish, they don't play around. You just boom, take it and the line will start to move. So the very first pitch, your focus has to be 100% on your bait. Who cares what else is going on? That first pitch to the dock, the floating raft, the boat, whatever it is, on that man-made structure, your focus has to be on your bait, on your line. Until that bait's back in the boat, do not assume a fish can't be there, because that's when he's gonna be there. Are you the only one home? Why was there a little one there? Why? Why was there a pounder? But one thing I want to get across when I'm fishing docks, you don't always have to have a lot of lead and cover. Like this area has fantastic stuff. Logs, weeds, pads, you name it. It's got little things like the, you know, sea-doos and boats, and it's got docks, and it's got a variety of things that the fish can hide on, like this. You see what I mean? You look at that and you say to yourself, okay, he's catching them. They're not big bubbas, but you know what? If I put this bait, game hog, rodent, or jig, or craw, in the right spot, those are gonna get a lot bigger. But it's all about presentation, bait selection on docks. And I'm gonna try to show you today how important it is to pay attention. Never think it's too shallow. Never think it's too deep. Sounds like an oxymoron, but it's not, because if it's something that bass can use going along a shoreline, they'll find it. And if you put your bait there, good chance you're gonna catch them. Not rocket science. That fish came off of, oh, I don't know, maybe 12 inches of water. He picked up the bait, he just slowly started to swim. We're gonna keep going. Hopefully put a couple of the real big guys in the boats. But I wanna show you different things to look for. See the boats I was fishing here, the docks and stuff? Look what's back here. A little bit of pads. It gets really shallow and skinny and stuff. Is there a fish there? Could be. But it's important to pay attention sometimes if you see towels on a reeling and things like that, that people are there. If they're actually swimming, you don't wanna do that. That's disrespectful. Find another dock. But if no one's there and the dock looks occupied or the night before or whatever, fish could still find it. Make a few pitches. Nothing there, move on. But look to your left, look to your right. A lot of times those fish use those things that are just, if they get spooked off, they'll find anything that's comfortable to hide in until they want to go back under the dock. Today my choice is the game hog. You know why? You think, okay, you've seen me use the jig a lot, rodent and things like that. Rodent and craw are good choices too. But what I want to do is let them take it, grab it, close their mouth on it, and swim away. It's not so much giving me the time to set, because I'm paying attention, but a lot of times they'll come up real fast and stuff, see the jig and grab it and go. The soft plastic, like the game hog, when they put their mouth on this, they don't let it go. It's phenomenal. You want it. Man, oh man, look at this. Nice log between these two docks here. And it's got some weed on it. And it's got a largemouth bass on it. See that? Unbelievable, eh? Dock. And then you get a largemouth bass. He's acting like he's way, really big, way bigger than he really is. But you know what? It doesn't matter. It's a chunk. And it's so important, to keep that bait wet. Bait's wet, you're gonna catch. Sounds simple. But so many guys just run from dock to dock, man. You know, they're just look at the most obvious stuff. And the less obvious stuff between has got these. Again, 2 pound fish maybe, you know, but who cares? But the point is, I'm trying to show you that you hit everything, your focus is on the docks. I wanna go fish docks today. But you look at everything between, pads, tree, anything in the water, you fish it and you'll catch them. Re-rig, let's catch another one. A lot of times, I'll look for the secondary stuff first and I'll fish it. You know why? Because on docks, most guys run to the most obvious stuff. Secondary stuff, put a few pitches in. I can't tell you how many times I've got good fish on the stuff beside the good stuff, the most obvious stuff. Backs of a boat, the very shallow part of a dock. You know, the boat, where the boat goes down in the transom, you know, and the guy starts the motors and stuff, stirs up the bottom. You got a little more of a cavity there. Fish could feel comfortable sitting in that. And I work my way out towards the deeper stuff. Just puts me in a different position, possibly that the fish haven't seen. So have that bait always falling in the front of the dock. This way I just approach it from the sides, hit the back, and then come out. Mind you, if they're really aggressive, they'll be on the fronts, on ladders, and things like that. But sometimes you just gotta coax them. Not every fish is sitting in the exact same spot on a dock. Some will tell you where they are. They'll give you an idea where they are, how aggressive they are. But sometimes you just gotta pick it apart. Take your time, trolling motor, slow, angle the boat, pick it apart. What about you, huh? On a dock, just a chunk, huh? Look at them. I love how they fight. All about the pursuit. One of the easiest ways to find largemouth bass is to fish boat docks. One of the easiest ways, even if you got jet skiers and swimmers, you name it. See, they want to see a fish, let them go. Go on, you. Have a good day. It doesn't matter. A lot of times, those things push the bass into the docks. They're sitting on a weed or a stump or something. Jet skis and swimmers and pontoon boats go by, push the fish under the stuff that both you and I like to fish, and that's docks. I want a dock! Dock! As for tackle, it all depends on the water clarity and where those docks are situated on what kind of body water I'm fishing. If it's real dirty water, I can get away with braid, you know I'm gonna throw the braid. I'll throw in the 7-3, maybe big jig rod. But on lakes with clear water, where I can see what's going on, see the fish come out, etc., I use the 7-4 heavy power, 20-25 pound fluorocarbon, the sliding tungsten weights, because again, any soft plastics I use, would it be the game hog, the rodent, or even a rage craw, I want that little tungsten sinker going in the bottom, stirring it up, dropping down, and that bait just fluttering down. Something about that fluttering bait, those fish see it, whether they're just fluttering down or on the bottom and moving real subtle, they pick it up, they feel nothing but a little piece of soft plastics. They just eat it up. Here he comes again. Look at the size of you. There you are. There's another one. Now long times, you gotta wait and wait. Put the bait in and just let them eat it. See, that's not a bad fish. But you gotta work them sometimes, man. I tell you, not a real big one at all. He's just a chunk, you know, 2+. Big fat head, big fat mouth, large mouth. You keep that yap closed, you won't get in trouble. Oh, just nice to see them like that, eh? Light bite, ready to go back? Go on, they're gonna go right back there, eh? Circling around, working it, fishing it. When you're fishing docks with clear water, if you don't wear polarized glasses to see your fish, you're wasting your time. That's a bold statement, but it's true. A lot of times, in that murky water, you can get away with it because the fish just come out, grab your bait. But in the clear water, especially on docks, if you can see them come out, you can be patient, go back for them. But it just gives you an idea sometimes how many fish maybe come out and you don't see because you pull your bait out and go another spot. Clear water will show you how many docks probably do have them on it. So it's frustrating sometimes because it's clear, they get spooky and stuff, or the murky stuff and dirty water, they come out, wham, and eat it. They're a bit less, you know, a bit more forgiving. But in the clear water, just goes to show you. Pick the right baits, rod, line, hook, everything just right. Present the bait, they will come out. You just gotta be patient and you gotta catch them. Let's keep going. And now it's time for the Cottage Angler, presented by Lucky Strike. More fish fight with Lucky Strike.
Hi, I'm Strike King Pro Luke Estel, and today I'm gonna talk to you about punching little clumps of grass with a Strike King Rage Craw. What I like to use is a 4-aught straight shank hook. Depending on how thick the grass is, a 3/4 to 1.25 ounce tungsten weight, and then on the end of my braid or above the weight, I like to use a little crappie stop. It's a bobber stop, and what that does is I keep it about an inch above the weight, and it allows that bait to wiggle down into the grass. So I just keep it an inch above like that, and then I can shake it and then it'll go right down in the grass. And basically you rig it like every other soft plastic, put about a 1/2 inch into it, bringing up over the eyelet. Just a Texas rigget. You make sure it's weedless. Make sure that point of that hook does not come out because it'll get hung in the grass. Make sure my bobber stop is about an inch or so above my weight. It's a great bait to throw in clumps of grass when the fish aren't very active, when they're staying in the middle of them clumps, and then you can pick those fish apart. You know, instead, sometimes a lot of guys like to throw around the edges, but when they're not getting bit, you switch to a rage crawl and start punching these grass clumps, and you can have great success doing it. Right here, we got a couple grass clumps right here, and I'm gonna show you how I do it. I just ease up to it, and I'm just gonna pitch right in the middle of that. Let it fall to the bottom. Once it hits the bottom, I'll shake it a couple times, and then I pull it right back out. Then I go to the next one. Let it fall to the bottom. A lot of times the bass will hit it as it falls through the mat. I shake it a couple times, and then I pitch it right back in there. If you're fishing mats, you can just go down a mat and just keep continually pitching. But out here, when we're fishing in grass clumps like that, I can just ease the trolling motor to the next grass clump, take a couple pitches, let it sink to the bottom, jerk it a couple times, reel it right back in.
Here's another scenario to think about. You come to a boat, the dock that's floating comes way out. The support systems are about halfway back to the dock, okay? Because Yen's floating. Yes, the fish could be sitting there, but he's up high, suspended. But if there's a boat beside it, like this boat here, that boat is more in the water, okay? It sinks down more. Possibly, just possibly, a fish could look at that and just feel more comfortable because he can get tucked up right against it. He's still closer to the bottom, okay? He's not right up suspended underneath the part of the dock that's way out and it's floating. So a lot of times I'll fish the boat up along the side, I let it sink, I don't do anything. And I just lift, I'm watching it all the time. Because if I see a little twitch and stuff like that, you know what's gonna happen. But that boat being there on a floating dock, I'll pitch to the boat first. Work it right along the side, then I'll put it to the end of the dock. Before I start going all the way around and working the dock, look for those fish that are really aggressive. But if it's got a boat, try the side of the boat first, because that boat's going to be lower in the water. The fish just sometimes feel nice and tucked up against it. Sometimes you think that they come out sideways. Sometimes they do. When you're doing docks, keep your focus on all the stuff around you, even on the docks you're fishing. Like that, see? Sometimes you gotta coax them out. In the grass. You see how far back I stay from the dock? I'm not way up inside it there. I'll let them fight. Turn them a few times, okay? Just a nice, solid, fat fish. But that's exactly what I mean, staying back. You know I love to fish docks. Bing, 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 bang, all over the place. And it's so imperative to keep your attention of where you are and put them in there. Take some pictures of a couple of fish, okay? It's a nice largemouth. Anybody take those in tournaments right there, boy. Wow. You win it for safekeeping. Put your live well on. But I mean, your fishing docks, you take a look at it. You dissect it in your mind where you think the fish should be. Shady side, dark side, weed, wood. You just dissect it. Don't just go to a dock thinking, you know, one and for all the same. It's not. And let the fish tell you where they position. A lot of times when they're aggressive like this, when the sun's like this, whoa, they'll come out. You don't have to go right up on top of them, because sometimes they'll come out, you'll throw it in, and then they'll shake your bait, your boat goes on top of them, you blow it out. Take your time, work it efficiently, and you'll catch those bass just like that one. You see, I pop one on that side here, I start working around like this, putting in those dark shadows. And I can see they got a rope system holding this floating raft. So you gotta pay attention to that kind of stuff, because even if you do hook a fish in there, it's a good chance if he's a good size, he's gonna wrap up around that stuff. So I wanna make sure I just work all these edges like this, and it's tempting to pitch over these ropes, okay? You say to yourself, wow, look at that, there's an opening right here. Above water there is, but you got a rope from that side coming down, this side coming down, and that rope on top there. Forget it. When your boat gets in a different angle, pitch in there, so you get a direct line of fighting that fish. You don't have to try to pull them over ropes, through ropes and chains and all that kind of stuff. It's a big mistake. Put it back up there. Back of the boat. That's a good one, I think. Just like the other one. See? Go back around. He's almost like the first fish. Almost like the first one, huh? Look where he's got it. He's all dazed and confused. All he saw was that little game hog come in there. And again, just had to eat it, eh? You just had to eat it. I think I have to put him in there. Put him in there, timer on. But you see what I mean? It's not rocket science, no matter what you do. If you're fishing lily pads, fishing topwater, jerkbait. But when you decide to fish docks, two things. Practice your accuracy before you go out. And if someone's on the dock and stuff, have respect. There's other docks where nobody's on, do those. But just dissect it. Look for those little spots. Get my heart rate back to normal. Make some pitches in there and see if one just stays real deep. Let's go. That's what I'm talking about. He's just a little bit better. Look how nice they look, eh? Gotta love those largemouth, boy. When they sit on those docks. In the clear water, you just stay back. Again, he's not a big fish. Gonna jump a bit? Nope. Look where I got him to. Perfect spot. X point, it's done. When it's in, it's done. They stay in. They don't come out. Oof. Wow, hey. You grab that little game hog. Look at them, eh? Chunky little bass, eh? Beautiful little things. Just like hunting them down, don't I, eh? Hunting you down. I wouldn't let you go again too, huh? You just giving me a great day fishing docks. Real big ones today? Nah. That one boathouse had three fish in a row. First couple are kind of decent. I got a few other ones that were, you know, chunks, but it's the way I like to fish. The docks, get in there, hunt them down. Next time you go out, use some of the tips you saw on this show, some of the things that I do, and I guarantee you, you're gonna send me a picture of the big ones that I didn't get today that you'll get, but you use the same tips and tactics that I used to catch them. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time on Extreme Angler TV. Let's go home. And if you want more Extreme Angler, go to our website, ExtremeAnglerTV.com, and I'm sure you'll find us on all your popular social networks, YouTube, Twitter, and Facebook, because I know you're gonna like us.